The 32nd annual Sundance Film Festival wraps up tomorrow evening in Park City, Utah. Each year, Hollywood's most powerful players converge on the ski resort town to bid for the rights to distribute some of the industry's best new independent features. Eric Davis, managing editor of the movie website Fandango, attended the festival and is here to tell us all about it. Eric, good morning.
Good morning.
So Netflix and Amazon really played a big role in outbidding some of these big studios.
Yeah, they brought bags of money to Sundance this year. You know, last year they weren't really invited to the party. This year they were the party, you know, snagged a lot of films before the festival, during the festival. One movie in particular, Amazon acquired for $10 million, Manchester by the Sea. Mm-hmm. This is arguably the best movie that I saw at Sundance. Really emotional family drama starring Casey Affleck from the guy who directed You Can Count on Me, which snagged a couple of Oscar nominations. So I think Amazon and Netflix, you know, they want to acquire movies, they want to be a big player at Sundance, but they also want to get to the Oscars, and they're really trying to get there.
How does this change the game, Eric?
Well, I think, you know, it changes the game in terms of a lot of these movies are going to be streaming. You know, Netflix, Amazon, some of them are going to go day and date. So they're not even going to be in many theaters. They're just going to be on Netflix.
Is that desirable if you're a director and it's your film?
Well, if it's a small movie that's going to go up against these summer blockbusters, you know, like a Me and Earl and the Dying Girl last year, one Sundance, didn't make a lot of money at the box office. You know, so if it's a big Oscar contender, those movies tend to want to be on as many screens as possible. You know, we saw Netflix take Beasts of No Nation last year.
Yeah.
And that didn't get any Oscar nominations. Yeah. And I think not being on 2,000 screens hurt its chances at the Oscars. So, you know, and another big movie this year, The Birth of a Nation. Netflix tried to bid $20 million for it, lost that bid because its director wanted to be on 2,000 screens.
Quickly, tell us, what is this movie about?
Yeah, this was the biggest story at a Sundance. Fox Searchlight paid $17.5 million for it, which was a record at all film festivals. It's based on a real-life story of Nat Turner, who led a grisly slave rebellion back in the 1830s. I was at the premiere of this movie. Let me tell you, I saw things I've never seen before. There was a standing ovation for this film before it even began.
Wow.
When it ended, the entire theater was up on their feet through the credits in the pitch black, which is something I've never seen at Sundance before, or any festival that I've been to. So just a very powerful movie, a very necessary movie, especially right now with the Oscar stuff. This is a film that made a lot of waves.
Well, one of your favorite films out of Sundance is Sing Street, which is from director John Carney, who also gave us the film Once.
Yes, this is a really great coming-of-age movie. It's sweet. It's about a boy from Dublin in 1985 who starts a rock band to woo his dream girl. A lot of great music from the 80s in this, from The Cure, from Duran Duran.
Right.
Great original music, too. They had the two boys from the film that played the guitar. They played songs from the movie afterwards. I saw this film at 9 a.m. and it got a wild standing ovation. You can get a standing ovation.
You're not even awake at
that point. Yeah, at 9 a.m., then you know you got something that you could brag about.
Well, from music to magic, tell us about Slight.
Yeah, this movie I would pitch is kind of Chronicle meets Iron Man meets Menace to Society. Low-budget genre film about a street magician who's also a drug dealer and what happens when his worlds collide. Really good film. You know, first-time director J.D. Dillard, this is the kind of movie where he goes from this to, like, a big superhero movie. It reminds me of Colin Trevorrow from a couple of years ago, had Safety Not Guaranteed, another low-budget genre movie at Sundance. He went from that to Jurassic World. Now he's directing a Star Wars movie. And so that's what we kind of see, these stories at Sundance, of these directors who emerge and then go on to direct some of the biggest movies of all time.
Daniel Radcliffe of Harry Potter fame also got a lot of attention this week for a film called Swiss Army Man.
This is the weirdest movie. Maybe the weirdest movie I've ever seen at Sundance. You know, yeah, this kind of has a Castaway vibe to it. Paul Dano plays a guy who's stranded on an island. He befriends the corpse of a dead body that washes ashore, played by Daniel Radcliffe. To give you a quick example of how weird this movie is, it starts off with Paul Dano riding Daniel Radcliffe's corpse like a jet ski, fueled by Radcliffe's flatulence. And that's not even the weirdest thing that happens in this movie. You know, in some ways, it's a fascinating film about a man who falls in love with his own isolation. In many other ways, it's just a straight-up weird movie.
Well, I want to ask you about Christine, because when I heard that they were making this a movie, a story of a journalist who kills herself on air, commits suicide, I mean, how is this movie?
Yeah, this is a real-life story, and this is one of two movies on Christine's life that was at Sundance. The other was a documentary. This is a narrative. Rebecca Hall plays her, probably the performance of her career. She's sensational in this film, and it's a really somber and sad look at this woman who, you know, has some, you know, bipolar and has some issues, and back then in the 1970s, nobody really paid attention to that kind of stuff, and she's really trying to get ahead in the world of television, and she just keeps getting knocked down, and you feel for her, and just a fantastic performance from Rebecca Hall.
Finally, Sundance screened a very interesting documentary on the former disgraced Congressman Anthony Weiner.
Yes.
With extraordinary access.
Extraordinary access. Yeah, you've never been this close to a political scandal before. They follow Anthony Weiner when he's running for mayor. Of course, halfway through his run for mayor, there's a sexting scandal that breaks out.
Yeah.
And all kinds of, you know, you get inside the campaign, you get to see what happens when a scandal breaks out within a campaign. How do they handle it? You're behind closed doors. You're in his apartment with Huma, his wife,
wow.
who really is the tragic character in this film. You know, you really feel for her. You can see what this is putting her through. And Anthony Weiner, yeah, I mean, he's just at
I'm
one point.
They didn't say stop rolling.
Yeah, really.
Well, you need to stop.
The
rolling.
Filmmaker does ask him. He's like, "Why are you letting me film this?" Literally.
All right, Eric Davis. Thanks so much. A lot of good stuff.
Thanks.